Today, we're going to work on a pressure assist toilet. Pressure assist. Doesn't use much water, but you get a great flush. And what we're doing here is we're going to cut the water off. And obviously, they're missing a handle, so we're going to use our channel lock pliers to cut the water off to the tank. Oh, sorry, I don't have an extra handle on me at the time, so we will make do right now. Need to flush it one more time to get the pressure off of the tank. Okay, that one more flush should relieve the pressure from the tank, giving us the opportunity to work on it without the water splashing and exploding all over us. And this is the handle mechanism, the system that operates the pressure assist, which pushes down on the Sloan flush mate cartridge. And since we do see water building up at the top of the flushmate cartridge right in here, that's not normal. So what we're going to do is we're going to replace the Sloan flush mount cartridge. And as you can see there, there's a 1-800 number. You can also call the manufacturer for advice or parts. And this is my six-way screwdriver, which you can handle Phillips, flatheads, and use it as a nut driver. Okay, now we don't need to disconnect both sides, because once we get one, we can just slide it right out the other side there, just like that. And that's the rod to the flush handle. This is the new Sloan FlushMate cartridge. And of course, we're going to remove the old one. I'm just removing the actuator because it makes it easier to get the channel lock pliers into here. I mean, that's the special tool of the day. We're going to use a pair of channel lock pliers, but we're going to use the handle side of it. Interesting, huh? Okay. And as you see, we just slide it down the slots. And we're just going to slowly turn the cartridge and turn it and turn it until we do get it loose and pull it out. You know, with a pressure assist toilet, this is probably the biggest problem you're going to have with a pressure assist. Now you see all the red coloring. This just shows me that this system has very, very hard water, and actually they don't recommend you use a pressure assist on a system that has hard water. Well, obviously, because it will wear out the cartridge a lot faster than normal. And before I left here, I did recommend that they replace this toilet with a standard toilet. And this is the new Sloan FlushMate cartridge. I'm going to screw down in here. Back to the hard water. If you do, in your place of business or home, have where your tank is getting all this debris and buildup, rustic look like you've seen here, you really should look into having a water softener installed into your system to soften your water. Hard water is very hard on plumbing. One other problem I've ran into in the past with a pressure assist is where the tank actually itself just kind of sprung a small leak, and in that case you want to replace the whole pressure assist tank, which is not really a serious thing to do either. And the great part about this is they have the 1-800 number, the model number, and all that stuff right there. If you want to match it up, just call the manufacturer, get the exact same tank, go right back in, and you shouldn't have any issues. Okay, here we are putting the flush assembly in place, back in place. And this is the actuator, and when you do put this in, the part that I'm screwing on right now, you want to have about a quarter of an inch space between that and that rod right there, because you don't want the rod laying right on top of it, because it will continue to flush. So you just want to have it a little gap so that you have some room to actually push it down and flush it. And here we go with my six-way screwdriver, using the nut driver end. Yep, see right there? Six-way because you have the flat edge, the Phillips. And you see me popping it down into the nut driver part. Okay, now let's slowly turn the water to the tank back on. And actually, while we're at it, let me explain the supply line is actually just a 3/8 supply line to this particular pressure assist. Manufacturers they do recommend that you put a half inch supply line in place of this supply line. With the half inch, you'll get more volume. But like I said, in this this particular project, I do recommend that they go with a standard toilet because of the hard water. Because they're going to continue to have problems with this one, with this hard water. But this will get them by for now.